Well, today is a joyous, wonderful occasion. As a dad, I've waited a long time for this. And today we get to unite two very, very special people. Now, I've known Lindsay all of her life. And from the moment she came into the world, there was no doubt that the world was going to be a better place because she was in this world. She's kind, she's intelligent, she's loving, devoted, energetic, and just plain fun to be around. And James, over the years, I've found you to be a young man full of kindness, great substance, intelligence, and devotion to my daughter. I've come to see that you are her calm in the storm. I've come to love and appreciate you, James. And I'm grateful that you've taken such good care of my daughter. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. So James, the scripture is telling us that you should be willing to lay down your life for your wife. This world is a little crazy, and it's easy to lose sight of the important things in life. It's easy to lose sight of how we should live as a husband and wife, how we to love each other. Your job is to protect her integrity and to stand tall and take the fire when things come her way that might cause her to receive ridicule, that you would stand up for her against all odds as the one who loves her most. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. Scripture says the two shall become one flesh. Today, you're going to be one. Now, you're going to differ in hobbies. You're going to differ in some friends, right? You're going to differ in what you do with your day for work. But ultimately, you should be pursuing a oneness. And that oneness is understanding each other, encouraging each other, loving each other in any way you possibly can.
James, wow. It's crazy, right? It's beyond surreal. Standing here eye to eye, committing each other to one another in the deepest ways for forever. Truthfully, I was not sure I could get to this point in my life emotionally. Between my cracks, insecurity, stubbornness, history, there lied a need and want to be loved in the ways you love me. To be seen and wanted in the ways you look at me and need me. My pride would tell me I did not need it. My past would tell me I did not deserve. And yet, here you are. All my doubts dissipate when I am shielded in your arms, firmly pressed against your body, as if it is to say, you are safe here. I fit perfectly next to you. Curved edges, broken off pieces, loose ends, they all fit. James, I hope you feel the same sense of security with me. I hope you know I love you eternally just as you are. Crungriness, pranks. Gotcha. Late night game nights with the boys and all. I love your dad vibes. The way you turn on NPR in every room you're in, and right when you walk in the door. I love how you love a good routine and will do anything in your power to stick to it. I love your wit and oftentimes inappropriate sarcastic jokes. You are the funniest person I know, even though I am embarrassed most of the time. To this day, I find myself looking at you and feeling the unpredictable tingle a person gets when they are straight smitten with someone. I am smitten with you, and it just keeps growing with each passing day. You are the Aang to my Katara, the Rice to my eggs, and the Rilo to my Eddie. Mm. I promise to continue to improve on my cleaning and organizational practices at home. You know it's a dopamine buzz. I promise to always surprise you with your favorite food when you've had a longer, rough day. I promise to always hide and try to scare you when you get home. I promise to continue making you laugh with my weird and bizarre sense of humor. I promise to put us first and to consistently and continually reevaluate my actions to make sure I am living out this promise. I promise to never lack in laughter, compassion, or support in this relationship. I will give everything I am in this partnership because we're beyond worth it. We deserve it. And I love you eternally.
I love you, Lindsay. Thank you for standing by me all these years through the immaturity of college, through the stress of grad school, through all my lame jokes that I'm glad that you find funny. I wouldn't be the person standing here today if it wasn't for all your loving advice, for your unwavering support. I promise to respect you as an individual, to celebrate with you when times are good, to support you when times are difficult, and to love you as my wife. I also promise to begrudgingly take the dogs out when they're running late, or if you've had a long day working with your kids and their families. I love you. I love the life that we've made together. I look forward to our future together, and I promise to grow stronger together.
James and Lindy, upon your solemn vows that you have made here today, and upon your sacred pledge to love one another for the rest of your lives, in accordance with the laws of God and of this state, it gives me great pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and what God has joined together, let no one put asunder. James, you may kiss your bride.
As the cascades stand, wherever I sleep tonight, be with her lamb. And this iron will quit, ain't got nothing on you, kid. Yeah.